Hi everybody, it's me. I don't even know where to begin. It's been so long since I've done a video. You know, I was on that almost 2 month vacation that my sister went with us, and we had a fantastic time. I loved having my sister with us and or with me, and you know, we bonded more than what we have in a long time, and we just had a great time. And it was great being able to show her some things that she has never seen before, because stuff that I had already done and seen, and but then there were, you know, a bunch of new stuff also. We started out in San Antonio and did the river walk, and went from there to Carlsbad, and I have my list of where we went. Okay, we started out in San Antonio, then to Carlsbad, Tucson, Las Vegas, Los Angeles, the Sequoia National Park, San Francisco, my favorite of all cities, to the Redwood Forest. We went to Mount St. Helens, Seattle, which I was really disappointed in. I'll tell you why in a minute. Spokane, we just stopped overnight in there. Glacier National Park, it was all right. Yellowstone, Salt Lake City, Zion, Bryce Canyon, that was in Cedar City, Utah, Arches National Park, Canyonlands. We didn't get to Canyonlands, but we went to Arches. That's in Moab, Utah, and then Denver, and then we went on to Amarillo. Again, that was just a one-night stop. Then to Dallas, and home. So we went to a lot of places. There's so much that we did, and you know, the highlights were, of course, I always love San Antonio. I just love that city, and I love San Francisco. We had a great time in Las Vegas. My sister won $300. I think you already saw some of those videos that I did while we were traveling, and so this might be some repeats. Great time in Las Vegas. In Los Angeles, we got on the Jay Leno show, so that was lots of fun. I'm not a big fan of Jay Leno, but my husband and sister are. And it was just fun being on the show, you know. It was a lot of fun. Let me see. From Los Angeles, we went to, I guess, Sequoia National Park, and the trees were fabulous, you know, huge. They weren't so tall. They were just big around in by volume and weight. They were the largest living thing in the world, you know. And and then we went to San Francisco, my favorite of all cities. Alcatraz. I love Alcatraz. Someone commented when I guess from Facebook or maybe from the video that I did from San Francisco, I don't remember, but said that they took the tour at night of Alcatraz, and it was really spooky and different than what you see and do during the day. So if I ever get back there, I want to do that tour at night, and I think it would be fun. So from San Francisco, then there was the Redwood Forest. We drove up the Oregon coast along the Pacific Ocean. It was just beautiful, just beautiful. And of course, Seattle. Seattle was the one place on this vacation that I couldn't wait to get to, and I wanted to go, and I've been wanting to go there for a long time. I was never so disappointed. I mean, we had a great time there. We went whale watching, which was fantastic. We saw orca whales and a humpback whale and some other wildlife and stuff, but that was fantastic. And we ate at the Space Needle. It's this big, huge, tall thing. Has a revolving restaurant at the top. We ate there. That was great. But Seattle, the city itself, I thought was just cold and dirty, and it reminded, not cold temperature wise, but just cold, you know. And it reminded me a lot of Philadelphia. And Philadelphia is like that, and dirty and cold, and or even New York and New Orleans, and not New Orleans so much, but or New York, but Philadelphia, you know, it's, I don't know. I just thought Seattle was going to be a harbor town, you know, with marinas and lots of boats and fishermen coming in at the end of the day with their catch and little cottages all over and, you know, a lot of water. I don't know. It just, maybe we just weren't in the right place, but the city itself was just nothing like what I expected. So anyway, from there, you know, let me see what else. Yellowstone, been there, done that. Glacier National Park, a lot of the glaciers have melted, so they're predicting, I think, by 2020 that there won't even be any left. I think that's what it said. Something like that. And so that was good. I loved Mount St. Helens. I think I did a short video from there. That was very interesting and just amazing. Yellowstone, you know, Old Faithful, lots of buffalo. we saw some grizzly bears there. Oh, my God. I think that was the highlight of the trip for my sister. That was a mother and two cubs. And there was this one husband and wife there that had a telescope. And they had it set up to where you could see them up close, and they let us look through it, and it was amazing. You know, to see grizzly bears in the wild was just fantastic, and it was just great. And we could see them good with our binoculars, too, but it was just great. It was just, we'd never expected to see any. I mean, we saw deer, and we saw moose. We didn't see a moose. We saw the what are those deer? Mule deers, I guess they're called. And we saw elk, and we saw lots of buffalo and goats and sheep. We even saw a sheep herder, you know, that he had lots of his sheep, and we had to wait while they crossed the road. I mean, a huge herd. And they had two dogs with them that were herding the sheep. It was just cool. And, you know, it's not something you see every day. So that was fun. And let's see, Yellowstone and Denver. We'd never really spend any time in Denver. So we were there over the 4th of July. But there was a ban on fireworks pretty much from all the drought. And so we really didn't see any fireworks. But we grilled some hamburgers and stuff and, you know, had a good time anyway. Dallas, you know, same old thing, you know, we had a great time in Dallas too, and I don't even remember what we did there, but we had a good time. I don't know, all in all, we had a great time on the vacation. The RV was great. We only had one problem. Our engine light came on when we were heading towards Tucson, so we ended up having to spend a couple extra days there to get it checked out because we had to wait till a shop. Of course, you always, when things like that happen, it's always over a weekend. And we got in on a Friday, and so we had to wait till Monday to be able to take it to the right shop to get it checked. And as it turned out, you know, they did the diagnostics and everything, couldn't pinpoint it. It could be one of a million things. And everything from changing the filter to, I don't know, something major. And so we said, well, you know, I told him, just change the filter and let us be on our way. And then if we still have the problem, we'll stop somewhere else and do something. So we did. They changed the filter, and we never had another problem. So we were lucky. And pretty much, you know, we did have a low tire at one truck stop we were at. I guess it was a trucker or somebody stopped by and said, hey, you know, your tire looks kind of bad, looks kind of low. And we checked it out, and sure enough, so we had, it was real worn. So we got two new tires right there. Took a half hour. They had them in stock, and, you know, got that done. So didn't hold us up very long. And so that's about the only things we had to do. And we put over 6,000 miles on that motorhome on this trip. So I guess we were pretty lucky. But we are looking to trade it in whenever we get time to go somewhere to look at them. We did look at some in Tucson, and but they just didn't have, you know, what we wanted. So that's the vacation. Okay, I came home from that. My sister went home. 3 days later or so, I had to repack and go to my mom's over in Florida. My mom, during the vacation, apparently a week or maybe it was 2 weeks, I think it was a week, 2 weeks before we got home. She had fallen and hit her head, and my brother called an ambulance and had her, and she was taken to the hospital. She had to have some stitches in the back of her head, and they did an x-ray to make sure she didn't have a concussion, and at that time found that her cancer had spread to her brain. And my brother didn't call us for a week to let us know, because my mom begged him not to call us for some reason. I don't know why. So anyway, he called, and they put her in a rehab hospital, and we called and talked to her and everything, and said, of course, we'd be there as soon as we got back. She was okay. She had to get her physical therapy because her leg had given way, and which is why she fell. So they had to do physical therapy. Said she couldn't go home until she could walk. Well, that wasn't going to happen because it's the brain cancer, I'm sure, which made her leg weak, and it was not really going to get much stronger. So I went over and, managed to get her discharged, and we have her at home now. And I don't know if I told you, but she was diagnosed with metastatic lung cancer about 2 months ago. 2.5, 3 months ago, I guess. And they said they didn't know where it originated, but and my mom refused to have further testing, so they couldn't really say. But she had some tumors on her neck, and she had the lung cancer. And so now we know it spread to her brain. She's not in any pain to speak of. She gets headaches occasionally, but she was getting headaches while I was there. But other than that, she's not really in pain. She has a wound, a sore on her spine, on her lower back, that was an open wound. And that was giving her some trouble because she couldn't lay on her back and stuff, and she had a hard time getting comfortable. She's losing weight. She's not eating. She eats about 3 or 4 spoonfuls of food and then doesn't want any more. And then an hour or two later, she may try again. And so the doctor told us, originally they told her 6 months to a year when they first diagnosed the cancer. Now that it's in her brain, her doctor tells me he would be surprised if she lasts a month. My sister didn't think she was going to last a week. Once we got her home, it was really difficult to, get her up into the bathroom. And after about 2 days of that or 3 days of that, she was not getting up. She wasn't cooperating. And, it was like dead weight trying to lift her. And so then, my brother was at his wit's end because he wasn't getting any sleep and she wasn't getting any sleep, and it was just awful. And he wanted her back in the home. And I said, no, you said you were going to take care of her. This is what you're going to do. I said, call hospice. That's what they're there for, because she was already on a hospice team. And I hired a CNA to come at night to sit with her. When my brother works, he works a night shift, at that time it was 9 to 2 or something like that. Now he's working 10 to 2. And she stays with her during that time. And so she did that for 2 nights, but now my sister does that. So, but anyway, he did call hospice, and so she's on her pain pills now rather than Advil or Tylenol, which is really helping. She got sleep, my brother got sleep, and he had a new lease on life, or a new whole new outlook the next day, and felt so much better. He's doing a fantastic job of taking care of her. I'm glad he's there with her, and that she can be at home to die where she wants to be. And I just don't know when it's going to happen. My sister sent a picture yesterday, and she's just wasting away to nothing. And Connie had her 2 little granddaughters there, and Mom was smiling. So she's still interested in things going on around her, so she hasn't totally withdrawn yet. But she is going through the process. So that's my mom. And then just recently my husband's brother had a motorcycle accident, hurt his knee and his ankle, and was okay, but was having an operation on his knee and threw a blood clot and went to his lung and heart, and he had open heart surgery, and after that he's not responding, and they're to the point, and it's been over a week, and they're to the point now to where they're going to take him off the respirator, but he was breathing over the respirator, so, you know, I don't know how long he's going to stay alive, but they, in the EEG or whichever it was, they said there was little to no brain activity, and so he's dying. So we have that, and then there's some other family things going on, and it's just been crazy. It's been crazy few months. It's been a really crazy few months. So on to better things. I'm hoping this isn't going to be too long, but, you know, it's been forever since I made a video. It seems everybody's making long ones, so here we go. I need diversions. The Olympics are starting tonight. I can't wait. I'm so excited about that. I love the Olympics. But anyway, on my trip, I finished some projects I was working on. The first one was the shawl that I was doing. Remember, I made one for my sister. Hers was kind of red. Mine's more of the auburn browns and greens color. So I made that, and I love it. I love it. I love it. You know, it's just enough to throw over your shoulders. Well, I have to stretch it out. It stretches out bigger. I probably haven't. Upside down, too. Yeah, I did. Anyway, this is it. This is the straw. It's beautiful. I love it. Can you see it? It's real lacy. Anyway, that's my shawl. And then, you remember the red sweater I was working on? I finished it. Here it is. I haven't blocked it yet, but I have finished it. And it's great. And it fits. It fits! Oh my god. So here's the sweater. It's a short sleeve sweater. Let me see if I can just show the bottom half here. I need to block it, and then you stretch it to size when you do that and let it dry. But this is the sweater. Cool, huh? So there's that. And just recently I started making this pair of socks. They say for men, but I'm making it my size. And here they are, the socks. I love the color of the yarn. This is the yarn. I don't have the tag right now to tell you what it is or the type, but it's 100% merino superwash. I know that. Wool. It has a cool pattern to it. I mean, you have the ribbing here at the top, and then you have this kind of a pattern here, and I don't know, it's kind of fun to do. It's called a Skype stitch. But anyway, I'm loving that. It's, you know, relaxing me and giving me time to just sit and relax. So my dad is doing fantastic. I went to see him the other day, and I'm about to go see him now as soon as I finish this video. He's doing great. When I came to see him the other day, Tuesday, after being away, he looked over at me and he smiled and waved, you know. you know, he doesn't really know who I am, but he knows I'm somebody he knows. But he just doesn't know who or remember my name or anything. I tried to tell him about my mom, but he doesn't even remember mom. I said, "Do you remember mom?" He said, "No." I said, "You don't remember your wife?" "No." So, you know, I told him about it, but because maybe in some way he'll comprehend that. And, you know, and so on some level be able to understand it. Not that he needs to, but anyway, I felt like I needed to tell him. His sister, his only living relative, died. She died July 2nd. My cousin didn't even call me. Another cousin saw the obituary in the paper and told another cousin, who then called me, who I'm more in touch with on Facebook and everything. And you know, and but then finally her husband, my cousin's husband, the daughter of my aunt who died, sent me an email about it and sent me a copy of the obituary. So my dad's sister, his last sister, died, and so she was 90, And my dad's 85, and he's the last one of their family still alive. And my mom is the only one in her family alive. She only had one sister, and she died real young. So, you know, my family's falling apart. My family's just falling apart. I don't know. Anyway, I gotta go. I had meatloaf for dinner last night, which I love. My husband is down at the beach. I decided I couldn't go because of another family matter that came up, and I'm staying here. And he went down to the beach and took Lawrence. So the two of them are down at the beach, I hope, having a great time. I hope he's able to handle Lawrence. I mean, Lawrence is four, and he can be a handful at times. I mean, he's busy, busy, busy all the time. He loves video games, though, and so we put a few games on my husband's, my old iPad, for him to play, and he has his Leap Pad, you know, his leapfrog iPad thing, you know, it's called a Leap Pad. He has that, and, you know, and the beach. So I hope they're having a good time. My husband needed that break, and when he gets home, of course, he'll be flying up to see his brother. And anyway, so that's about it. That's what's going on with me. That's why I haven't been on for so long. I just had no idea where to begin or start or what all to tell you. You know, some stuff you just don't want to talk about. And anyway, so if you watched this far, thanks for watching. And I guess I'll talk to y'all again soon. I hope to get back into vlogging and do it more often. So I'll talk to you then. Thanks. Bye.